Next problem, a pressure gauge 6 meters above the bottom of the tank containing a liquid reads 90 kilopascal. Another gauge height 4 meters reads 103 kilopascal. Determine the specific weight of the liquid. So, ito naman ay meron daw tayong tangke. So, illustrating, ito yung tangke natin. Dito sa tank na ito, merong dalawang pressure gauge reading. As you can recall, a pressure gauge 6 meter above the bottom. So, drawing natin yan. 6 meter above the bottom. So, mula daw sa ilalim, meron tayo ditong 6 meters. Above the bottom of the tank containing a liquid reads 90 kilopascal. So, at this point, we have a reading. Let's denote this siguro as P1. So, P1 is 90 kilopascal. Another gauge, height 4 meter, reads 103 kilopascal. Ooh. Okay, so from 4 meters naman, meron daw tayo ditong So, at this point naman of the, let's draw an imaginary line. At this point, oops, yeah. Let me, sige na, dito na lang. At this point, meron tayong reading na P2 at 103 kilopascal. So, 103 kPa. Determine the specific weight of the liquid. So, ibig sabihin, kahit ito, napupuno naman yata ito ng liquid na yun. Okay, so, itong tangking ito ay merong laman na liquid na merong dalawang klase ng reading. P1 is 90 kilopascal. Tapos, yung pangalawang reading ay P2, 103 kilopascal. So, ang tinatanong is specific weight ng liquid. So, ano ba yon? Again, from, recall that the given is, I will write down, P1 is equal to 90, P2 is equal to 103. So, ang tinatanong is specific weight. So, recall that the solution, I mean, the formula for the difference between pressure head is equal to eto, P2 minus P1. So, P2 minus pagandahin lang natin, P2 minus P1, pangit pa rin, is equal to the unit weight of the liquid multiplied by height. Now, let's check kung ano pa yung mga given natin. We know that we have 103 kilopascal in here. So, we can say that 103 kilopascal is 103 times 1000, right? So, 103, this is in pascal for P2. Tapos, si P1, 90. So, let's say 90 times 1000. This is your P1 in pascal is equal to gamma, or specific weight is still missing. So, let's denote that as your gamma. Now, when we talk about height, anong ilalagay mo dyang height? Sige nga, analyze first the problem. Diba? These two given heights are referenced from the bottom. So, itong isa 6 meters, itong isa naman 4 meters from the bottom. Therefore, you cannot say that this is the height or nor this is the height already. Because when we are talking about pressure, the point between the two pressure head, I mean, two pressure points, are the considered height of the pressure itself. So, ibig kong sabihin, ang difference between point 1 and point 2 from the illustration, we can say that 6 minus 4, that is 2 meters. Paano ko nasabing 2 meters? Again, i-recall natin itong illustration. Diba? Ayan, the difference between point 1 and point 2 is this part. So, h. In this case, kasi naka-inclined lang siya. Pero imagine if perpendicular distance between point 1 and point 2, that is your h. So, sa makatuwid, the difference between P1 and P2 is just 2 meters. So, therefore, ang gagamitin nating height dito is 2 meters. So, ilan na yung makukuha natin gamma? So, direct substitution naman pala 103,000 minus 90,000 divided by 2. So, the answer is 6,500 newton per cubic meter. So, hindi tayo pwedeng basta-basta mag-substitute ng given, no? Kung may nakita na kayo na 6 meters tapos 4 meters, yun na agad yung ilalagay nyo dito. No, you have to understand that the distance between these two points is what we will consider as the height of the pressure. Okay, so 2 meters before tayo mag-direct substitution. So, yun lang naman yung concept nito. And I hope na kahit wala pa siyang figure, wala siyang drawing, kung ito lang talaga yung given, masasagutan nyo by translating the problem into a figure like this. Okay, so that's the final answer, 6.5 meters.